people, I'm back. Yes, it's me. Missing the tube, missing doing videos, lack of content. So I thought I'd come back and irritate you with something else. And it's one of my favourite horror films and my favourite all-time werewolf film. It's American Werewolf. The German edition, this one is. And it's complete with my foot next to me because I banged it. So I sort of have to leave it hanging, sort of in stardom at the moment. Right, okay, so this is a German edition, very limited, and I've seen it in groups as well, people that have got one, and then there's other people saying, oh, I never got mine, I really wish I could get one, and you don't even get them on eBay either, unless they're stupid prices. But I was lucky to get it through a website in Germany. The guy who actually sold them gave me the link and said, here's the link for Germany, there's only a few in, quickly go and get one. So I thought, yes, 4K American Werewolf. And this has got a lot of goodies inside it. So it's wicked. And I absolutely love this film. This film was awesome. Straight from the moors. The first time I watched this was many years after it was made. Probably 20 years after it was made. And I saw the clip. I didn't even see the very start of it. I saw it from the slaughtered lamb onwards with the classic walk in the pub and no one says a word and they just stare at you. You made me miss. I never miss. Well, anyway, this is, I think, the third edition that I've now bought of this. I bought originally a Steelbook from Play. Then I bought an Arrows one, which I actually done a video on, which is sitting up there. Well, I will get rid of that one now because I've no purpose of doubling them. And now this one. So let's get this dive in, shall we? As I said, it's a special one. It's hard to get. They're sort of like a German equivalent of Everything Blue over here, but they make even less of them, so it's even harder to get hold of. Oh, there's a serious glare coming. So you get a lot of goodies inside. I'm going to show you them all. And obviously the film as well, which most important of all is 4K. So you get your box, which is different. It's not a slip box. It's a pull-up box. You got artwork of the Moors. Cool. There's your two hero characters. Or one hero. Well, no, they are hero characters, even though one dies, you still get to see it later on. I don't know what East, I don't know what that is. I don't know if they put that in German and that's the reason why it says that. But they actually at least gave you the English words on the title on it anyway. Saying that, I did do my video of Back to the Future not that long ago, and because the Steelbooks had the words in German, some guy got the right hump and started moaning. You can see all my content on it. And it's just a miserable git, really. So it's like, well, if you don't like it, just buy the one with the English subtitles, or English words on the front. I don't care. Right, okay. Right, let's take this out. Oh, sorry, it opens like a book. It doesn't pull out like a strike. So what am I greeted with first? So I'm greeted with beer mats. And we all need beer mats at this time of the year with all this COVID shit to drink our beers at home because all the pubs are shut. So, saying that, you're not allowed loads of friends in your house, so I was about to say you can have three friends and yourself and all have one together, but you can't even do that, can you? So they give you four of these. East Proctor Brewery. Okay, I don't know what East Proctor Brewery is. I don't know if it's, does it have these beer mats in the film? Do they look just like that? And does it have those words? Because then that'll make sense what was on the back of the actual box set itself. But anyway, the thick cardboard, the moment you get them soaked, they'll get completely ruined. They're one-off disposable use if you use them in that purpose. You get a little... Oh, all right, okay, it's a sticker. Not really going to use it. It looks nicer just in the box, unless you just plonk it somewhere. Beware the moon, beware the moon, with claw marks. And obviously, quite a nice section of this film was set in the underground. The bit where the snotty man was being chased down by the werewolf, and that was fun. And that is actually my favourite bit of the film, because you couldn't see the werewolf. You never really got to see the werewolf until right at the end for the very first time, when he's clambering up that elevator and you get to see the werewolf coming towards him from the bottom. That's the first time you got to see him properly. So there you go, there's that one. This I'm looking forward to because I do like the soundtrack. I do like Blue Moon and all the other songs in it, and the one where he's changing for the first time. And they give you the soundtrack of the songs from the film in it. So you actually get some of the songs. Sam Cooke done the Blue Moon one, I believe. Yeah, there we go. But you've also got others, and you've also got tunes from the film as well, like dialogues and bits like that. So you land up with 18 tracks altogether on there. Oh, that Wicked Dream sequence. Jenny Agutter, who was just gorgeous back then. And now, so you get that. That's nice. That's just a bit like the Steelbook transfer that I actually got when I bought the original Steelbook of it. Same cover. Insides, just selling material. That's gonna be nothing. That's gonna go in the bin. And then you got this. I think these are the usual postcards. Although going by that one, it looks like porn. So that remember that porn bit in the cinema that you saw. And he says, so what are you doing with my wife? And he says, I'm not your wife or something. I can't remember. And he just walks out and goes, hilarious. I can't get him out. That's annoying. That's annoying. Right, okay, done it. Okay, so what we got? So we got a non-stop orgy. That's the bloke, I think, the funny one with the moustache or something. Landis. So back to the scenes, original poster, I remember it was that one, that's good. I've never seen anything like that, that was quite good. It's with all the puppets. This guy looks really good for his age, by the way, this American Werewolf. Because I believe he was supposed to be at the Comic Con last year, which obviously because of the virus has been taken away. And it showed a picture of what he looks like now. And yeah, he looks really good for his age, and you can tell it's him straight away. It's got a quick glimpse, and it's like, yeah, that's the guy. He's just a little older, but he looks really good. Look after himself. Right, so there we go. So there's your postcards. Oh, that's a weird one. Not too keen on that one. Anyway, so you get, I think it's 7 or 8 of those. I don't really want the porn one. It's the one sitting on the top. I'll put that one near the bottom, and one of the other cooler ones, I think, at the front. I think that looks good. So you get the big, massive poster as well, which is a slaughtered lamb poster, which is good. You know, these slaughtered lambs, this poster, you can actually, I've seen it, a few people have owned them. You can get a wooden made pub sign slaughtered lamb that's carved out of wood, and it looks really, really cool, and I really love it. Something I think they go for around about 60 quid or something like that. I know a few websites that do them. You can always get in contact with me if you really, really want one. And then we get the behind the scenes book. We do really cool the London oh my god. I've caught the virus. No, I haven't. Right, okay. If I have you safe, because you're on screen. I'm on screen. Right, okay. So that's the cover for it. It's like it's all going to be in. That's the only show. I'll have to go by pictures because it's actually all in German. The words, that is. That's the downside, I suppose, to getting something from another country. You can't understand it all. Not that I do, because to be honest, every book I've got of every box set I've ever had, I've never ever read any of them, ever. I flick through it once, I look at the pictures, I might flick through it a second time at some point, and then that's it, the end. I never ever look at it again, but it's nice to just have them, especially if you're a big fan of a certain movie like this one. And there's loads and loads of pictures behind the scenes, by the way, in this. So, you know, pictures is more my thing rather than reading. I like to buy illustrated books that have got lots of pictures in them and glossy stuff and stuff like that. So that's what this has basically got. Oh, what's that? Is that like advertising Big Mac back there now and a restaurant food? That's good. So you get a lot of them, and 100 pages. 100 pages. Oh, it's the orgy one again. See you next Wednesday. So they used to have cinemas back in the 80s that just do porn films, and people used to just, single blokes, I gather, during the lunch break, go off and watch one. I don't know. Something like that. Don't know. there are someone. Okay, so there you go. That's the book, and then you got the final piece, which of course is what you really buy it for, which is the film itself. It's a little bit of flimsy, not the best quality. It's okay. It's just thick card. I've had better quality ones. And then you've got look, the Moors. This is when they walk down to the village just before it gets dark and find a slaughtered lamb. Great scene, great segment. First 15 minutes of the film, my favourite. and the underground scene chasing that bloke, my favourite bits. But I love the Moors, like, really atmospheric sound. They were really cold then as well. When it was filmed, they were freezing cold. You could see the steam coming off of the bodies. Excellent. So here's the three versions of it. It does play in English. I had to check that first. And if I didn't, I guess I'd be really disappointed. But it does. So you got the Werewolf, the original film, in HD, which has like Piccadilly Circus underground map on it, if you're familiar with London or you live near London, like me. Tottenham Court Road is just the natural Blu-ray American Werewolf one. And then I believe this will be the extras one, the Hampstead Heath area. That makes the bonus material. It does even say bonus material in English on that, so that's always a good sign. So I don't know if my one was... I don't think it was 4K. I think it was a 2K remastered version when I had this, when I bought this one. So I am upgrading the game now, so that's good. So really, really pleased with that. There we go. And I like this song as well. It's very cool. So there we go. There you go. I hope you like that one. That's my American Werewolf in London box set one. Strangely enough, I haven't seen a YouTube video of one, because while I was waiting for this, because I got it delayed by a week, I was looking around seeing, has anyone done one on YouTube so I can have a better look at it? You know, people were sending loads of pictures on the Facebook group, movie groups, but no one's got one, and that's, oh damn, I really want to have a look at it, but I haven't. Anyway, this is another one that arrived not too long ago. This is Mulan, the Disney version. I'm not big into Disney cartoon films. I'm not big into the Disney live-action films. Although, saying that, I do own the Jungle Book version, and I do own, I think there's one other one as well, Lion King one as well, because my kids wanted it. But now I own the Mulan one, because you can get away with it not looking so Disney-ish as the cartoon. And I've never seen the cartoon, by the way. And a lot of people are saying it's not as good as the cartoon because it misses loads of bits. But I enjoyed it. Been into martial arts and stuff like that. I found this a good film. This is lovely. It's a lovely, lovely still. And I'm glad it don't have the words, because I like words along the bottom having the title. But this one, no, because it's done like a watercolour with some italics on it and water paint looking version. So it comes out really, really nice. And you've just got the Disney Mulan on the back. You've even got Chinese down the side, which is a really nice touch. I like that. And on the back you've got the sword, because the sword was quite an important part of the film for her, because she stole it to go on her quest. And if you take it out inside, then you've got, obviously, as usual, you've got the Blu-ray and the 4K discs. So there we go, there's the two. And inside you've got her as the warrior, and you've got her as what she really is, or what she becomes, shows herself to be in the film later. Really impressive steelbook, really, really nicely made. Film, I did enjoy it. If you're not a big Disney fan and you just want a one-off film and you've not seen the original and you don't know what it's about, it's got a lot of good action story, good storyline. I do like the characters in it. Jet Li is in this, who I didn't even know because of the way the makeup was, and I haven't seen him in a movie in so long. And then I saw him and it's like, oh my god, that Jet Li. I saw the whole film and I didn't recognise who Jet Li was. And it's like, okay, alright, great. He had a good part. And there are lots of other characters with good parts which are her companions in the film. Good wire work and sword play in it as well. And a guy called, is it Jason Scott Lee, who you remember from Bruce Lee story? He was in that. He was Bruce Lee in it. He's in this too. And the guy never ages. He looks fantastic for his age. He's the bad guy in it. And he does a good part as well. I've always used to seeing him as the good guy. But nevertheless, he's the bad one. So there you go. I wanted to show you that. I hope you like it. I hope you've got one yourself. And if you haven't, keep on looking around for it. And you might be able to get one on eBay. Because I don't think it's something a lot of scalpers are aware of. So if someone's selling one, you might get a good bargain. Original price, £55. That's what I paid for it. So if you're looking around that sort of price mark, you haven't been conned. So you can go for it straight from there. I do have lots of other normal Amore stuff, but I don't really want to show you them. I just want to really get through these two with you and hope you enjoyed them. So have a nice rest of the weekend. I'll speak to you all soon.